This episode is being recorded out of Shop Talk Podcast Studios in Oak Park, Michigan. For more information, visit www.shoptalkpod.com.
What up, though? It's your boy, DTM, Deontay the Motivator.
And I'm just a D-girl from around the way with a whole lot of shit to say. It's your girl, KD.
Gia, man, and this is the number one podcast of the year, man. Together we are
Relationship reality.
What's happening? So, KD, what's good? What's going on? How was your week?
You know, another day, another dollar.
There it is. All right, so today we have a special guest in the building. Go ahead, introduce yourself and tell the people anything, something about you.
Miesha, man. Just me. I don't know what to tell you. Right. Y'all hear a whole lot soon.
That fool Miesha said Miesha, and that's it.
Just Miesha and,
it's just my name.
All right, so we're going to start it off like we always started off. We got this game we like to play. It's called
About That Life.
Yeah. And so what that means is I'm going to throw out a series of things for you. And if you are about that life, meaning you've done it or you will do it, then you take a shot. If not, you sit there and you let the shot just look at you. All right. So just a couple of them. Just a couple. All right. So the first one for About That Life is car sex in the back seat while someone else is driving. Are you about that life?
You mean like a limo or just it don't matter? Or
it don't matter. It could be an Uber driver.
It really don't matter though.
Yeah. All right, so that's three. That's about that life. Oh, yeah. The face is amazing. All right.
I'm hot already.
So, yeah.
I told you it get hot in here. That's why.
All right, so let's go to the next one. The next one is shots and food off someone. Would you eat it or drink it off someone, body shots or whatever? Are you about that life?
So it's so funny. When we went to the Dirty Show, I actually did eat sushi off somebody.
All right, so that's one.
So
and cookies.
If I do it.
If you do it. There we go. We're in there.
She like. Oh, yeah.
All right. So the last one for About That Life is pool or hot tub sex. Are you?
That's not fair.
About that life.
Everybody in the world does it. They have a whole hot tub sex place.
There's a lot
Oasis.
Of people who
call
have not,
Oasis.
There's a lot of people who has not been there, though.
They need to go. We're about off State Street.
You ever been?
Yes.
It's the bomb.com.
So, you're, okay. All right, so we got three that is about that life, and that's it for this segment of About That Life for today. So we're going to move on to the next joint.
What is happening?
What are you doing? Hey, nothing.
Are we having technical difficulties, engineer?
We in here like swimwear, you know. All right, so we got a new segment that we just brought today. You are popping the cherry of this new segment. So I hope you are ready. So this is
Do we need shots for this?
Did we say something about shots for this one? I don't remember.
Because if you hesitate, you gotta take a shot.
Okay, so this is called the lightning round. So I got two sets of the lightning round. One for you and then one for KD.
Oh, I got my own?
You got your own.
Oh Lord.
Because if I get her the lightning round and you listening to her, you're gonna already be thinking of the answer. So I had to think outside the box.
I wish your ass stay in the box some damn time.
I don't mind doing that either, but you know what I'm saying? So how this works is, this is kind of like a this or that. Have you ever heard that? You ever heard of that before? All right, so this or that. Basically, I'm going to give you two different things, and then you got to pick whichever one rings your bell, like whichever one you're with. All right? And it goes, it's a range of a couple different things. You got to go fair. Don't think about it. Don't hesitate. Just
if you hesitate,
answer
you
got to
do a shot.
So KD is going to keep count on how many shots you got to do so that we can just keep it going. All right?
Ooh.
You ready? Here we go. All right. Chicken or steak?
Chicken.
Man or woman?
Man.
Getting head or giving head?
Getting head.
Swallow or spit?
Spit.
That was a little hesitation. Right. Doggy, that's a shot.
Doggy style or drinking beer?
Oh, two shots. Two shots.
Whips or handcuffs?
Whips.
Pussy pics or dick pics?
Pussy pics.
Lingerie or naked?
Naked.
Gag balls or getting choked?
Getting choked.
Drunk sex or makeup sex?
Drunk sex.
Boom, there it is. That's it. That's two. It. So she got two shots to
take.
Got that's
two. Don't take that that's one. It. I'll pull you up another one. Pull up, drink.
I was just about to say.
All right. So now it's Katie's turn for her lightning round.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
And we're going to have our guest, Miesha, go ahead and keep a count on how many hesitations she had during this. Ready?
Ready.
Ready? All right, here we go. We're going to start off smooth like we did with her. Text or call?
Call. Boom. Lies. Text. I take a shot for that just because I lied.
Whoa, she yelled that out quick. All right, ready? Keep going. Let's go. Steak or coffee?
Coffee.
Boom. Public sex or handicap sex?
Handicap sex?
Like a handicap threesome.
What is that?
Handicap, a threesome with
like
a handicap
somebody
threesome.
That's disabled?
Oh, public sex.
Boom. Parents walking in on you masturbating or you walking in on your parents masturbating?
Them walking in on me.
Girth or limb?
Girth.
Phone sex or dirty text?
Dirty text.
Small penis or premature ejaculation?
That's two.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. She gave the answer.
I guess premature ejaculation. That's like a double bad right. thing. Like, you want other. Bad or worse? Like
one or the other. That's it.
Premature, I don't want no little dick. I'm straight. You keep your belly button to yourself.
Ooh, all right. That's it. That's it. How many she got to do? How many she got? She got two? All right. So what y'all think about that lightning round?
Interesting.
You have to keep that segment on?
Yeah.
All right, bet. That's what's up.
Very interesting.
Okay, so let's move on. Let's get into the show portion. It was nasty.
A little bit.
You made it.
I know, but it's no ice.
What would? All right, man. All right, so I got a question.
He
want
to scrap.
I got a question for y'all.
What's the question, DTM?
There are three different types of threesomes. Mm-hmm. First, I want to ask, can you name the three? Katie,
yes.
I know you can because we went over this. So,
so it's three girls, right?
Yeah.
A girl, two girls and a guy,
mm-hmm.
two guys and a girl.
Yeah.
Well, it's three guys a threesome too, so it must be four.
I don't know. I didn't even think about that one, so I don't even know if I would put that one
I
in the category.
You were talking about like they had names, certain names. Mm-mm.
They probably do. Mm-hmm.
They probably do. I'm pretty sure they do. So the question is, have you guys tried any of those three? I guess you can't say four because ain't no three guys in here. So have you ever tried any of those three? And if not, would you be willing to try any of those three? Katie?
Yes, I would try. I guess all of them except two guys.
Okay.
Because I think that's gay.
Kind of weird.
Yeah, because it's like, in order for it to be a threesome, like, all three parties have to be engaged with one another.
Right, right.
So
I agree with that.
So, I'm not interested in two guys kissing, playing swords, or none of them. I'm good. That's probably drive me right on up, like, did y'all forget I was here? Yeah, no.
They probably might be of interest.
Right.
You gotta speak into the mic a little bit.
Sorry.
You say what happened?
I said they probably wouldn't be of interest to you if they playing swords.
Right.
Ooh.
They're like, why this bitch here?
Right.
Fish.
Whoa. All right. So you said yeah, mm-hmm. all but the two guys.
Yeah, I'm not down with that.
My issue.
Or three guys because I'm not a guy, so I can't participate.
Boom. I'm with that.
I'm down to try it for sure.
All three?
No,
all three. Yeah, all three.
It's three.
Yeah.
Well, no, I don't want to see nobody slapping
swords. You don't want the swords going?
So,
And so would it be the same thing if you have two girls, but both of them want to use strap?
I'm not down with that.
No, that's different. I'm down with that.
You're down with that, but what's the difference?
Don't nothing turn me on about two dudes together.
Yeah, I've even tried to watch like gay porn, and it's just not like two guys. It's just not. It's nothing sensual or like sexual or like damn, that's hot to watch two guys like go at each other.
I have nothing against it. Absolutely nothing against it.
I don't have nothing against it. It just don't do it for me. Like,
it's just something I ain't.
You know.
Okay. All right. So I got a scenario for you. You going over somebody's crib, right? You're about to get some. You're mm-hmm. about to go in. You know what you're going over there for, right? Mm-hmm. As you get over there, he invites you to the room, to his room. You go into his room, and when you look on the sheet, you notice that there is already a nut stain on the sheet. Are you doing?
So did he know that I was coming over there to fuck? Or only I knew I was going over there to fuck?
He knew you was coming over. Maybe he didn't know you was coming to, you know, get some. Maybe he thought you was coming to.
First of all, he should have never invited me in his room if he got nothing.
Exactly. Why you don't have clean sheets?
Because we not 12.
What if it's his? Like, what if he would just like.
It's still dirty.
What if he didn't notice it?
No.
Do he get a pass?
No,
because you about to have me on some sheets that you done had somebody else on yesterday.
What if he didn't know? What if he was just jacking off?
That's still nasty.
Yeah, you jacked off.
You thought you cleaned it up, but you didn't.
You can't clean it up. You gotta wash it.
I'm just playing devil's advocate.
How you clean it up?
I don't know. You get your little white wipe, you know, wet now.
A what?
A wet, wet wipe. A wet wipe, and you go in.
No. He should have washed the sheets. Let's be a grown up.
Yes. So definitely be a grown up because I done deal with enough babies.
Exactly. We straight
on that.
I like, okay. All right. Bet. So next question is, have you ever sent somebody the wrong text? Like, if you was in the texting and then you sent the text to the wrong person, care to share what happened in that situation? You don't have to say name.
Oh, I don't know. I just usually, I'm kind of quick on my toes, so I can just switch it up. Like, you know, I know I sent that to you. I meant it like this, you know, like, I ain't about to tell you I text the wrong person.
Okay. Katie, you ever had that issue?
So I did. So let me tell you, before I was talking to my homegirl and we was like screenshotting another conversation and sending it to each other. Mm-hmm. So my goofy butt made a mistake and sent the person that I screenshotted the actual screenshots. And I was like,
oh, no, you can't get out of
it. But I didn't say I didn't say anything. I just sent the screenshot. And then I was just like, Taz had my phone. I don't know.
I was just about to say that, or I
would have
been like, you know, somebody.
Taz had my phone. I don't know what he did, but he was just taking pictures and made a mistake.
I definitely used somebody.
Whoops.
Wow. Okay.
Yes, I've done that.
Okay.
Blame the baby. When all else fails, blame the baby.
He'd be mad at the
baby. Right. He a baby. And this was like probably like 2 years ago, so he was only like 2 years old. So you definitely can't be mad at him. Them dimples popping.
Right. Right. He's definitely going to win you over.
Right.
So my thing, I did the same thing. I actually did it recently. I was planning a birthday getaway. And oh, I was texting my insider and, you know, trying to get everything together. But I was also texting KD at the same time. So I ended up sending one of the texts that was supposed to go to the insider, to KD. And she had no clue. Like, she didn't really know where to go with it. So she was like, well, let's just not do that then. Because the check was almost like.
No, I heard it's nothing to do in Jacksonville this time of year. So I responded like, okay, so let's not go to Jacksonville. Like, where did that even come from?
I'm looking at it. I don't even think I responded you back didn't. To her responding.
You didn't. That's what I'm like. Say. He is so like, weird.
I'm like, okay, bad. But. I said, I'm like, I'll let her know once we finish with the weekend that I got planned. Like, that one right there wasn't for you. Yeah.
You did tell me that. And I thought that was funny.
Yeah. I'm like, man, that's so.
I had somebody wrong call me, like, thinking I was somebody else.
Now, how you wrong call somebody else? Like,
so, this was a long time ago when I was in, like, I probably was in high school, probably about 10 years ago. And she was living with me. But she was going to see somebody else. Call me like, yeah, send me your address. I said, what? And she like, send me the address. And I'm like, all right, bet. I sent you our address.
Bitch, you live here. Right. What you mean?
You know exactly where the fuck to go.
You know where I live. So I'm going
to send you the address to the hospital.
Quick, to the morgue.
Drive yourself there.
Right. She lucky at that time I wasn't in this crazy state.
Nowadays.
This one here?
Whew.
Man.
I swear to God.
All right. So... toys or no toys, guys?
Bullets.
Just bullets. Nothing.
I don't like dildos.
So, Miesha, you just said something about you don't mind straps. So, do you mind dildo?
Wouldn't it be the same?
It's pretty much the same. I mean, the dildo. I was wondering that. Okay. The strap is just literally the strap. The dildo you put in the strap.
Oh.
Okay.
Wow, light just right. Went on 101. Like, aha!
101, there it is.
We learning.
So, no, I have no problem with this.
So, do you like to strap or do you like to get strapped, I guess? Is that how it works?
I like it all.
Like, you put the strap on or you...
Yes. Like,
so you're okay. on your pinky tip.
Do nothing to me that I can't do to you or we not getting it.
Period. So you're on your pinky tip.
Period. Period.
Okay.
So can you use the same strap? Like, if I got a strap and I'm using it on you, would you use that same strap on me? Or do we have, like, our own straps?
Certain, it depends. Some people, like, certain girls treat their straps like a nigga treat his dick. Like, she gonna put a condom on that bitch, fuck this bitch, and fuck that bitch, and fuck...
She gonna put a condom on the
fake, yes.
So hold on.
A fake,
so
yes.
She putting rubber on the plastic?
Yes. Okay. Or
that'll make me nervous though. Like, this a whole fake dick. Why you right. need a condom? You a whore with a plastic dick?
Yes.
Oh, I can't.
Yes.
can't you just boil out and get like 6 or 7 of them?
Yeah. You know what I
mean? Are they expensive?
It depends.
Yeah, you know they can get expensive though. I mean, we go to the toy like store. You see,
don't they got something that like ejaculate? Like you push a button and it shoot out.
Oh, I ain't never.
What?
if they don't, then don't steal that, y'all. You about to put a patent on that boy.
But it's like it's like different ones. I think the different, like, they got glass like, ones and flesh ones. And
the ones that look more like
a penis.
Yeah, them ones more expensive.
Because it's like flesh-like or whatever. Kind of like a pocket pussy. But
so don't get it from the liquor store?
No, probably not.
No.
Probably need to go to the back door of the liquor store.
They have like certain... The back door.
The back... Hey, that's the 25-hour
liquor store. Girl, and I don't...
You got to go
in
the daytime because they kill people at night.
Right. We haven't been there in a long time because every time you drive past, it's like yellow tape. But when you go in there, it's a back part. Yeah,
I walked in with my guns in my hand.
Like, it's because it's right next to that hotel or a motel, whatever. Yes. I don't know the difference, but
I'd have heard some
motels is for cheap people.
Okay, so it's a motel. It's like hourly, whatever. Yeah. So it's always yellow tape at either one of them. Mm. But when you go in a liquor store, like in the back, it's like a beaded area. And if you go back there, it's like literally a sex. Like they got like magazines, movies, toys.
I heard they have. Every
day.
And if you go, that's like, and on the back part of that, if you keep walking, it's a wall. If you knock on that wall 3 times, it slide back, and then they got the prostitutes back there.
Shut up.
So you gonna lie? We trying to. We gonna get sued.
Hey, nah, but they about to get business though. Like, what y'all saying that? Like,
they about to be me wondering like, what they saying?
They googling 25-hour boy.
They
right
like
now.
Fuck that yellow tape.
Story, yes.
Hey. Y'all petty.
All right.
I'm not playing with y'all.
So, all right, so let me ask you a question. So when having sex, we all know that sex is all about rhythm, right?
Mm-hmm.
Y'all agree?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so when you see somebody dancing, is that a preview of what you're about to get in the bed? Meaning that if they dancing and they super off rhythm, off beat, can't really catch the beat, can't move, can't figure this thing out, are you about to get the same thing when you get them in the bed?
I don't think so. Only because, like, if you off rhythm, that means you just can't catch the beat. Like, I would just suggest not having sex to music.
Yeah, but think about it. If I'm hitting it.
No, because.
And you moving out when you should be moving in, you bobbing when you should be weaving, it's going to be an issue.
That don't got nothing to do with dancing, though. That's.
Because it's a rhythm. Like, y'all got to be on the same rhythm.
I feel what you're saying. But I don't know, because it's, I don't know if it would be different, because like that certain girl couldn't dance, couldn't keep a beat or none of that. But when we were doing those things, we didn't have problems.
See?
But I don't know about a dude. Like, I ain't never really like, oh, let me see how you dance.
Right.
Like, you know? Like if you at the club and you see him on the floor and
I had never experienced it.
I think the dancing would be more for men to watch a woman, like, see how sensual she is. See, like, how she, like, grind her hips. And, like, I don't think women ever be like, oh, girl, did you see the way he did that one move? Probably could fuck. Like,
I don't know, because when we went to the Dirty Show, man who played off as if he pulled somebody out the crowd, but we found out later that was his girl, he hit a couple moves that had you looking like, oh, my God.
That's true.
I was like, oh, okay, let me look at that move. I wouldn't get my pencil out and thought it writing down. Like, okay, he grabbed the leg and then moved.
You are petty. Bone. That is true. I mean, because I've been to the strip club before, like the men's strip club, and for them it's more like focused on dancing, right, than being naked. Like they be having whole ass routines, like whole ass outfits, like the whole thing, like where women is more like just take your clothes off and walk around this pole, whatever. But like with men, they be having like routines and hookups, and every now and then they pull their penis out. Like it's not. So I guess, I don't know.
I guess the question is, when you looking at him at the strip club, do you look at him based off of how they doing their moves? I'm like, oh, he probably good in bed.
But sometimes it don't necessarily be their moves. It be the way they handle the women that's up there.
Yeah.
Ain't that a move, though?
Yeah, but that's the part that gets you like, damn. Because he can, like, flip them and, like.
That's more like his personality.
Yeah, and like, it's like sex,
like,
though.
Like, if he aggressive like that.
Yeah.
Like, you know, but not. No.
Not like, oh, I like the way he rolled his hips. Like, yeah. No. He was that's not it.
My man was pop locking it.
Yeah, off, like, right? It's not that. But to see the way they, like, so aggressively handle the women on the stage, or, like, just flip them over all of a sudden, is like, damn, what's his name? Hey. Hi.
Yikes. All right. So next question. Eating pussy or sucking dick? Which one do you think you're better at?
Definitely eating pussy.
What makes you think that? Or that you did somebody tell you that, like, girl?
Had no complaints.
Which one easier? Like, is it easier to make a man come or a woman come?
A woman.
Really?
Is it because you're a woman and you know, you like, I know what I would like, so I would.
Yeah.
I always thought it'd be easier to make a man come because they just are so easy to make come.
It depends. They ain't in it. You just be doing it for practice because they like, nah, man.
Oh.
Or if they on drugs of some sort, you know what I'm saying? Certain
that's
drugs,
true.
You
well, that's
you
true.
Like, nigga, come. Like,
that's true.
So, yeah. Okay. So, all right, there you go.
I think I'm better at sucking dick.
You ate. Never mind.
Because I ain't never did the other thing.
I'm about to say, hold up.
You can't be good at something you never did.
I was about to say, I agree. So, you know.
No, I was about to say, hold up. You ate some pussy and I didn't.
No, I'm just saying, because I never have. Okay. That's how I think I'm better.
You cleared it up.
Yeah. Maybe in a couple weeks we'll ask it and I might have a different answer. Who knows?
Who knows?
Never knows.
Shots fired. All right. So being satisfied sexually, I want to help some people out, because sometimes you hear that word or you hear that phrase and it's a lot of different, you know, descriptions of what that means, mm-hmm. or definitions of what that means, I should say.
Am I waiting for this?
So can you describe to the people what that means to you to be satisfied sexually? And for you, we're going to have you do it twice, because you can do it for both angles. So that somebody can be like, oh, yeah, that means the same thing for me, or whatever. So to be satisfied sexually from a man means what?
I think, honestly, I don't think it's a difference.
Okay, so that make it easier. So,
I mean, I don't know. For me, I want to, for me to be satisfied, you got to be satisfied too. Like I said, don't do shit to me that I can't do to you. Like this a an even thing. I want to.
Well, you can't say that with a man though.
Yeah.
Because I mean, I'm not gonna. Obviously, I can't fucking. But,
right.
But okay, in that aspect, it's different. But just in general, like, I want you to be as satisfied as I am.
Yeah.
I want to know that you liking this as much as I do. You know. So.
That's that Libra.
I ain't no Libra.
You're not?
No.
What, you a Virgo?
Yes.
Ugh.
I like Virgo.
I like you better as Libra. No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm just kidding. I'm kidding.
I done had some bad experiences.
With Libras? With the Libras. Them Libra scales.
Both of them was Libras.
Really?
I need to know what these signs are. I don't be naughty.
My little sister Libra, though. Shout out to Lady Blaze.
I just know.
See?
That explains a lot.
See?
The twins Libras too.
That explains even more.
Who else Libras?
I'm still at it. I need to stay with
MJ.
MJ a Libra?
Yeah.
Who else? We know a lot of Libras, bro. Shout out to the Libras and y'all scales. Shout out to the Virgos and whatever y'all are. What is a Virgo?
Yeah, what month is that?
The Earth.
The who?
The women of the Earth.
What month is Virgo?
September, October. No, September. What's September?
Y'all sound like Mr. Chase.
August, September? Mm-hmm. August, September. Because the boys are Leos, but they like right on the Leo Virgo cusp.
Okay. All I know is Pisces.
Shout out
Gemini.
To the Pisces.
All I know is Pisces and Gemini.
The
ooh,
fish.
Yeah. That's y'all. Yep. Ooh.
Shout out to the Geminis.
You know
Teresa,
saying?
Gemini Geminis. Too.
Woo.
That explains a lot, don't it?
Teresa, cold piece. So.
Don't get Teresa started. Please. Shout out to my mama.
Man,
we gonna get her on.
Surviving T Petty.
Yeah, we gonna get her on.
Oh,
here.
Girl, I don't know.
Give her about 6 beers before she get here, and
ooh,
let her drink the other 6 while she here.
I'm not
gonna
play
be
with
going
you.
In. All right, so quick next question: can you or have you had sex in front of a crowd? And that's any kind of sex. That's sex, head.
Oh yeah.
Huh.
Oh yeah. Please do tell.
So we went for my birthday. We went to Ohio, and while we were there, we went to a like swingers club or whatever. So I sucked his dick at the table.
Oh,
girl, that was sucking dick, eating pussy. We were just sitting there.
I done heard about.
So I'm just sitting there. So I'm like, well, fuck it. I might as well. Suck my nigga dick. This one girl was like strapped to like this. What was that called?
The Bondage X.
The Bondage X.
Yeah.
And they was fucking like they have, so they have rooms that you can go in to close the door. Mm-hmm. Then they have like these beds that you can like have sex, and it's like tables where people can sit and watch you.
We playing cards and watching people have sex.
But these people
time.
Was like on the dance floor and like on the couches. So I'm like, oh, that's how we do it? All right. Cool. So, I sucked his dick.
Yeah. Had me in the middle of the club sucking my thumb. I ain't know what was going on.
He was like,
boing, boing.
He's talking about, I didn't see that coming. I'm like, hi. I swallowed it.
Man. Now you talk about pressure. There was super pressure on the nigga because. And you don't want to just be sitting there. You're so anxious now that it's happening. And you like, there's people watching. I got to, oh, my God, right? And then you like, uh-oh, wait a minute. Now I'm nervous. Don't come quick. Wait, please, wait. Don't let these people. Then I'm like, well, these people ain't going to never see me again. So you can do whenever you
can. Right.
I'm mad he was having that whole conversation with himself.
All that was going through.
All in his head.
All that was going through there.
He like, don't stop, don't stop, don't stop.
I'm like, don't stop. Wait, hold on, wait, stop. Wait, no, don't stop. Don't pay me no attention. Just keep going. I'm talking
just,
to myself.
Just forget it. Just forget it. Just do you.
Man. Yeah.
That was fun, though.
That was an amazing birthday.
Yeah, I don't. It was my birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah. It was amazing. I agree.
All right, so next question. What's one fantasy that's on your bucket list?
The beach.
Oh, we did that before.
Yeah.
In Miami, it's dope.
It is. Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Sex on the beach is bomb. You don't want to have sex in Belle Isle, though, because you might get AIDS.
I got to be some.
Yeah, but Miami, we did that in Miami for my birthday a couple years ago. It was amazing.
The beach. The
you got to make sure you got a blanket, though, not a towel.
Yeah.
Because the towel was sinking to the sand, and you end up with
sand
up your ass. all in your coochie. Right. It's all uncomfortable. It's like, oh my God. So yeah, thick blanket would be better. Note to self.
Okay. Okay.
I'm gonna keep that. Put that in the back of my head for when it go down.
Yep, for sure.
KD?
Huh?
What about yours?
A threesome.
Ah, okay. I think we're on the same
boat. I'm excited.
We're on the same boat. That's on the bucket list.
You know. The bucket list.
All right, so let's go to the next one. So what? We're gonna start with Miesha. What's the last lie and the most interesting lie that you told and got away with?
Oh gosh.
Yeah.
You about to have to do a shot. You gotta think that long.
She thinking because it must have been a lie. She like, which one was good? Which one was the best one?
She like, I told my people to listen to this. I don't know if
right.
I
want. Right, you could have put me out here. Well, hey. I've been doing a lot of lying lately. I mean, truth be told.
Bro!
I mean, shit.
Get to him. Don't hold back.
Y'all know all the stuff been happening with my dad. So, I just feel like I've been responsible so long. I'm ready to wild out. Like, I'm ready to be irresponsible. So
she the planned being irresponsible. Like, yep, it's my time.
She's like, I'm really sick of this shit. This grown-up shit, I need a break for a little while.
So I be like, oh, I'm going here. I be at the after hours. I be going. Be out all night.
Be partying. Everywhere.
Like, oh, my God. I done been to the after hours and been there to 7 o'clock in the morning.
Welp.
But I had a good ass time.
So I'm living my best life.
I wasn't doing no drug. Like I was drinking beer, just dancing. Like I didn't. It wasn't nothing crazy, but like, you know, certain people feel certain type of ways about the shit that I do. So whatever.
Okay.
Boom.
There it is.
Boom shakalaka.
I know Katie don't really lie, but I'm gonna still ask her just for the heck of it. Like, what? She like, everything is true.
I usually tell the don't. Truth. Look, I sound like a whole ass liar on here. I usually don't. I really usually don't.
I usually don't give a fuck to lie. So
I'm always cautious about people who say, okay, truthfully, or, you know. I'm gonna keep it 100. Okay, so normally you don't.
Right, so that's not the norm for you.
Right.
I don't know, I guess, probably like saying like, I ain't want to go to work. So I say like my car didn't start or I don't know, like something stupid.
That's
like
a high school ish.
I know, but what, who I'm a lie to?
Grow up.
No, but who I'm a lie to though? Like, no, damn, you said grow up.
Grow up, nigga, lie. Like,
no, but it's like, it's, I don't have like, you know, like,
that's
I don't know.
That's the way to be. You ain't got nothing like
that. I guess when I was in high school, I used to be like, yeah, you my real boyfriend. When really, I probably had another boyfriend. But. Maybe I needed his car, but shots fired.
Shots fired.
Pow.
He probably listening too. Like
he probably is. He probably still trying to follow me on social media.
Nope.
I knew it. Knew it.
Right. What about you?
All right. So for me, I don't really lie like that no more. Like I was.
Oh, I could think of some
from old though. Like,
I mean they are old.
Like my lies now be to my kids. Like now my battery dead. Dad, can I see your phone? My battery dead.
I ain't got no games on my phone.
Ain't no games.
Yeah, it be little stuff like that.
It don't
like,
even work.
Ain't no Apple.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I got a pear phone. Get away from me.
That's what they call a little white lie. You know, ain't nothing wrong with that.
All lies matter.
I don't know. So, let me see if I can think of one from back in the day. Like long, 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 long time ago.
Yeah,
back
in on that long,
that long, long,
that long, long, many longs ago. I don't know. I did a master reset on my mind, so a lot of this stuff I can't remember. She got to bring it back up to me, and I'd be like, huh? Yeah, so I don't remember. So, KD, you probably, you can't say because it's got to be something that I got away with. So, no, I don't have any because.
Oh, you said that you got away with?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Nah.
So, no, I don't have any because I'm married to Inspector Gadget, who is like Perry Mason out here. And she is going to catch you regardless. She's like, wait a minute. Right? And you don't even have to do nothing. Like, you don't have to set a trigger or nothing. She'll just kind of look at you with this real strange look. And she like, pull the glasses down a little bit, kind of like a grandma do. And then she'll push them back up. And then she'll look at you like she kind of see through you. And it should tell you everything that you think you might have thought and everything that you think you might have done and everything that you did. And you just be sitting there looking like a mind reader.
First of all, I did that to my boys. I did that to my boys a couple weeks ago because they thought they was getting away with some shit and I had to let them know.
She is a psycho.
You're not getting away with shit. Do you know these little MFers went and took all the fire alarms.
Yeah.
They went and took all the fire alarms down because they thought I had a hidden camera in their room.
Shit.
They like, how do you know? I'm like, this person had on this outfit. This is the way y'all went. This how y'all got there. This what she had on. They like, oh no, she got to have a camera. They took my baby teddy bear out the room and put it. Talking about it's a nanny cam in there. I'm like, y'all, listen, I sit on some shit for a little while until my investigation is complete. And then I come. I should work for the feds.
You should.
I got a 99% conviction rate.
No, the feds should work for you. You should employ them. Like, no. Hey,
if you want to know something, hit me up. I just need a couple information. I can find out the rest.
You really don't need nothing.
I gotta know who.
No, yeah. You don't. You just gotta know the situation. You gotta know why.
Mm-hmm. I gotta know who I'm finding out stuff about, though.
I don't think you do.
I gotta know the who.
I think you find out your own who.
Oh, yeah.
And then you add the rest of the who's to the who's.
That's true. Remember, I did that yesterday. I seen the news article, and I was trying to get to the bottom of the news article, and I done pulled up all the shit.
She know who did it, why they did it, where they was at.
Who they was with.
Who they was with, everything. Why they was show with. Who taking the fall for it, why they taking the fall. I'm like, what in everything. The world?
He's like, what is on your phone?
She the first one I hit up when I need to figure something out.
I'm like, well, I got you. Give me about 30 minutes.
Oh, she is calling you back?
Oh, KD is Spokio.
Give me about 30 minutes. I figure the shit out. It's cool.
I'm about to tell you what they doing.
For sure. All right. I got you, babe.
The best. So let's go in. So tell me something that instantly makes your pussy wet, not during sex.
Oh.
So not during sex, but when you if you hear something or if you see something, it instantly make your pussy just get straight moist.
Some of them words you be saying, like, don't do it.
Oh, I ain't gonna do it.
You already know.
Yeah, I ain't gonna do it.
Dog, you petty. You petty. But yeah, it's like certain words you say or like certain looks you give.
Okay.
Certain song, that song Bedroom Boom with Avant and the Yin Yang Twins. Okay. That's like an instant, like, that song make me so horny.
Shout out to them for doing that for you, for me. Appreciate that.
I'm gonna have to listen to that.
Girls off the chain.
Miesha, what about you?
I like to be put in my place. I want somebody to tell me to sit the fuck down and shut the fuck up. They gonna fuck me up.
No, she is.
Oh, look, she getting wet.
Look,
just telling
her. Well, she excited. Well, like
she like she
somebody can't. Who I can't say shut the fuck up to. They tell me to shut the fuck up. Ah!
Okay.
Waterfall.
Because I always gotta be. I always be the one popping.
Because she thinks she the boss of everybody.
Bitch, shut the fuck down. Shut the fuck up.
Okay. Okay. I do like that, too.
I'm trying to find somebody that's going to be like, no, bitch, you sit the fuck down.
I got that. My baby like, what I said. I'm like, oh, sorry.
Right. I be scared, too. Like, oh,
wait. You be scared. She be scared with me, though. Like, oh, shit. Since we got to shut up and be quiet. Like, damn, they did the same thing. Like, what you mean? Like, we not scared of him when he go upstairs.
When you walk away. Right. Shit, won't talk shit.
We be talking shit. Like, I don't know who the fuck he thought he was talking to.
Oh, so I'm like Debo.
I'm not an abusive relationship or anything, listeners.
I'm a Debo relationshipist.
Ooh, kill him.
Yikes. All right. So, the next question. Do y'all think that there are levels to cheating? Meaning?
Yes.
They are. Okay. So, do you think that if somebody got drunk and cheated versus somebody being sober and cheated, does that matter?
The same thing.
No, cheating is cheating.
No.
You said levels. Like, it's like emotional cheating. It's like physical.
That.
That's levels, though, right?
That's what I was.
That's what y'all was on, too.
So, yeah.
So which
one, levels.
Which one is worse?
I think emotional cheating is worse.
You say the same thing?
Get out my head.
At the same time? 2LW? So, emotional is worse.
Taste angels.
What makes that worse?
Because it's like you're giving your heart and your emotion to somebody else. It's not just sexual.
That's when you really gonna get fucked up.
For real.
So if somebody emotionally cheated but never had sex, is that worse than somebody who has sex but didn't get emotional with it?
No.
For me, it is, though, because, like, sex, especially for men, sex is such a detached thing where they could just have sex and move on. Like, it don't have to be no feelings there. It don't have to be no nothing. Right. But versus you giving your heart to somebody else or giving them, giving somebody a piece of your heart is giving them a huge part of who you are.
Yes.
So for you to give somebody else that part of you, for me, is way worse than just you fucking somebody.
Yes.
Because fucking is fucking. But love is, like, all of it's supposed to be only mine, but the love part is really supposed to be only mine. That bitch ain't died giving birth to your son.
Oh, God. Who you about to go there with?
Fuck you mean you love her. No, I'm just kidding.
Exactly.
I did, though.
Okay. All right.
What you think?
I think that emotional cheating is a little different because that's time invested. You know what I mean? Ain't no one night emotionally. You know,
right?
Ain't no one night stand emotionally. Like it, one night stand is like, you know, that you'd be like, oh, okay. I don't even remember her name. Okay, oh, you forgive me, I forgive you. All right, but yeah. You know, but emotionally, it's like, you know, y'all sharing internal information.
Yeah.
Versus,
and you always think about that person because they had such a huge impact emotionally on you. Like, so you always like wondering what they doing, wondering how they doing. You fuck somebody, you could fuck somebody not even know their name and go on about your day. You know what I'm saying? But emotional cheating is like, damn, I wonder what she doing right now. Or I wonder who she with right now, you know?
That's the one time I popped.
Yeah, because
when it was some love shit. Oh, no.
Like you see a text like, I fucked you, like, whatever. But you see a text like, I miss you, I love you, like, hold on, bitch. Like,
so, okay. So,
what you mean?
So let me ask
what you mean,
this.
Son?
So what if it's one-sided? What if, like, say it's me and you together and I cheat and she is emotionally involved?
Then that's not emotional, but that's not emotional cheating on your part.
Right. So are you still mad? She, if you see a text that says, I love you, and you're like, yeah, okay.
First of all, I fucked you before, so I could see how a bitch could get digmatized. So I get it.
Don't tell these people that. They're going to think I got good dick. I'm just an average dude now.
I like it.
I'm just an average dude now.
I like it. Welp.
Don't put me on that fetish, dude. Look, I got bad dick problems just like all the other bad dick niggas.
Lies. Lies.
You know what I'm saying? So, look. But I think emotionally cheating is time invested. But I think that comes from not getting something at the crib. Or something that you're looking for. You might not have shared that you were looking for it, but it's definitely something that you're missing at the crib.
Oh, yeah, that's 100%.
That you didn't share. And then that person that you are cheating with now, emotionally, you felt comfortable enough to share it with him or her.
That's true.
And so now they like, bet, I got one up in.
That's true. Because I feel like when you sexually cheat, it's not because you're necessarily missing something. It's because you want something different for whatever reason. When you emotionally cheat, like you said, you're missing something. It's literally something that's voided, and you're looking for it from somewhere. And either, like you said, either you haven't expressed it, so you the only person that know you missing it, or you did express it, and the expression, and it got brushed over.
You know how many times I was silently pissed at you, and you didn't even know it? You was like, what's wrong with you? What? And you, I'm like, you know what you did? Ooh, you.
Man, you.
You. Man. And you ain't did nothing. It was all me.
Like, I'm like, what'd I do?
It was all me.
I just be living my best life.
I just didn't share what was going on, but yeah, it was all me. All right, so next question. If you get caught cheating.
Hot.
Right? You get caught cheating.
That's why I'm making me
more. And you still with the... you get caught cheating, they forgive you. Or, no, let's flip it. You catch your mate cheating, right? Mm-hmm. You forgive them.
Mm-hmm.
But now they suspect that you might be cheating. Hmm. Do they have a right to bring that up and say something? Do you think it's a time limit on it? Like, if I got caught cheating today, I got 3 months before I can say anything about me thinking that you cheat. Like, is it a time limit on it? Can I say something if I feel like I know I cheated, but you forgave me, but now I feel like you cheating? Like, how
so do you feel like they cheating at the same time you was cheating, or are they cheating like after the fact?
After the fact. Like, maybe it could have been the same time, but you wasn't paying no attention at that
time. I mean, I don't think it's a time limit, because shit, a nigga like me would wait 2 years. Like, no, because on January 24th, 2017, I know you fucked that bitch. So I don't think it's a time limit. But I mean, as soon as you suspect it, you should say something, or else you're gonna drive yourself crazy.
Right. What you say?
I don't think it's no time limit, no. And it don't matter. If I forgave you, then that's it. That's the end of it.
Right.
So you can't hold on to that shit.
Right. It can't be like, well, I cheated because you cheated.
No.
Like, no, I cheated because I wanted to pop my coochie. Something. I don't know.
So would it be worse if, let's say, I cheated with Miesha, right? Mm-hmm. And then you cheated with Miesha, mm-hmm, to get me back. Is that worse than you cheating with somebody different?
No.
Like,
no.
Does the person matter? Because I know she's straight winning in this situation. She like, oh, I am that deal.
No. I mean, a cheat is a cheat is a cheat. It don't matter who.
No,
I feel like
that would be, for me, it would be easier, because I feel like you're just trying to get me back, because
meanwhile, she like, yes. First,
you know? Like, you a copy cheat.
Yeah. But I mean, I guess, like too, but some men.
Because I already hit it.
Like, right. But some men also feel like cheating with a woman is not cheating. So, that's a whole nother something right there.
That's a whole nother podcast right there.
Yeah,
we need to get a couple guys on here and just go through that whole podcast right there. Maybe get two.
Because I know some that think that that's cheating, and I know some that wouldn't care.
Yeah, because it's like, okay. Or.
But you know what, though? I think the cheating part would be if you're keeping it a secret.
Yes.
Right, you know which goes back to a couple podcasts ago when we talked about monogamy.
Right, so if you're keeping it a secret, then you
that's
cheating.
What makes it wrong.
It's kind of like
the secret is what makes it
even
wrong.
Even when you're in school, if you're cheating on your paper, it's because you're trying to secretly look at the answers from somewhere else.
Right,
right.
But if you got the answer sitting on the table and you like, you wasn't cheating, because it's in, it's, no, it's out in the open.
If you let it know, if you let it be known, but that's just, you decide to deal with it, then no.
But that's the same thing, like if you get pulled over with a pistol. If you tell them that the pistol in the car, they can't charge you with concealed weapon. They could charge you with possession, but they can't charge you with concealed weapon because you didn't conceal it.
If you're black, they're going to beat you. So be careful, y'all. Don't do that.
Well, I didn't say for y'all to do that. I'm just saying.
Be careful, y'all.
I'm just saying when you think of it that way, instead of concealed, now it's possession of.
It's all jail time.
I mean, yeah, you're going to jail.
It's all jail time.
Jail is jail. If you make it from the situation, like, I got a gun, like, pow.
Right.
You know.
That's it. Pow, pow.
Pow, pow. You get pow, pows.
All right. So, do you remember, Miesha, your first time with a guy?
No.
You don't?
No.
Is it because it was that bad or because it was that long ago?
Because I was that drunk.
She was drunk.
And then
do you remember your second time?
And here goes Samaya.
Yikes.
She know what happened. She got a baby.
So, your first time with a woman, you remember it?
Yes.
Damn, she said that quick.
Can you walk us through how that started?
Terrible. It was all terrible.
Terrible?
It started terrible?
It was.
How can it be terrible and it kept going? Like,
It was terrible when it kept going.
What was terrible about it?
Everything.
Did it get better, though? Like,
it was like one time she hit me and I was like, oh. Like, wait a minute. This ain't normal. But no, we waited. No. I don't know what was going on.
Nope. Mm-mm. No. She wasn't feeling it.
At all from the sound.
Her face, though. She like. Ugh.
All right, so, KD,
huh?
Do you remember your first time?
Yeah.
Walk us through how that started off. Was it good?
No.
What wasn't good about it?
It was painful. It was painful. It was stupid. It was like, I don't know. It was just dumb. Like, after the first time I had sex, I didn't even have sex again for like a year.
Right.
Because it was so dumb. It's like, it was painful. Then you bleed. And then it's just like, why the fuck do people want to do this?
I am sweating.
Painful, girl, and then Steven. You bleed. Yeah. So, okay. So when you think back now that you have some experience, do you feel like they were doing something wrong, or you just
I felt like because I was not in tune with my body. So I didn't know, like, the whole, like, your vagina's supposed to be really moist and it's supposed to be, like, you know, some juices flowing to make it not hurt. Like, sex is not supposed to be painful. No matter how big the penis is, the vagina push out babies. His dick ain't that big. So it should be enjoyable. It shouldn't be, like, painful. It shouldn't be uncomfortable. It should be, like, you know, you should have some shit going on to make it feel good. But when you're young, you don't know that. You just doing the act of whatever.
Okay. All right.
Like, me and you had sex for, I don't know how long before it became, like, fun.
It was fun for me from day one.
I mean, because for boys, it is, though. Yeah. Like, you jamming something inside of me. Of course it's fun for you.
Well, you jammed your love inside of me, so I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? Bye. But that's, I'm saying,
love don't hurt. Right. It ain't supposed to anyway.
I was about to say, sometimes love
can hurt. It ain't supposed to.
Sometimes love can hurt.
I wasn't trying to stick a cantaloupe into a pee hole.
Why you keep trying to tell these people? Listen, y'all, don't listen to her. She's just playing.
I've been drinking. I've been drinking.
She's just playing.
I've been drinking. Watermelon. Oh, sorry.
Okay. All right. So, the next question.
Ooh, oh, you bringing some memories with that.
I know. That's why I stopped.
The next question is,
I
didn't
want you to have to plug nobody's ears.
kissing after oral sex. Now, not just the regular oral sex, like you done came or he done came. Are you cool with kissing after oral sex?
Yes.
Yeah.
I love kissing after oral sex.
You?
Did I say oral sex?
So you did
oral sex.
You drinking Earl. You like, I love drinking. Earl. Hey, Earl. Yep. Earl sex.
I actually enjoyed kissing after that.
Do you?
I like the way I taste, though.
I do, too. I do, too. So, from the sounds of it, both of y'all like violent sex.
Violent?
Oh, she rough. Already said it. No, she said no.
You want to be violent? I do. I like to be choked and smacked.
That's violent.
Like
that's violent.
I like take my head and like jam it on the penis, like till my eyes start watering, my nose snot.
Yeah, ain't nothing like seeing the eyes water.
Don't do that, cause I'm gonna be pissed.
No, you not though. You're not gonna be pissed. You're gonna be like, yes, daddy. Yes. Yes, bitch. No. Yeah, I do.
Okay.
It's fun.
All right. So.
But you gotta take, that's come from a man taking control in the bedroom, though.
So have you ever used the whips and chain?
No.
Handcuffs?
Handcuffs, yes. We did have a whip.
We never used it.
But I don't think we used it.
Nah. At that time, I wasn't
I'm down, though.
Enough. I am now. I wasn't then because I wasn't mature enough. I felt like, you know, we just got out of slavery. You know what I'm saying? I, you know, Django, all that. Nah, I was like, nope, not doing it.
Bro, this nigga, dog.
Not doing it. For y'all who have not seen my wife, she is a half-breed. So
excuse
half of her
me,
should
don't
not.
Be disrespectful. I'm biracial.
Same thing.
Half-breed, these nuts in your mouth.
Now, that's nasty.
The only person to call me half breed is my mama.
There it is. But what I'm saying is,
you not my mama.
I'm not, but I'm your daddy.
Oh.
All right.
Pervert our listeners.
The whole show is perverted. What are you talking about? That's what we do.
Whoops.
That's what we do. That's what made us the number one show in the world right now.
This is the reality of relationships.
I'm trying to tell you, and we going from every different angle. So, ask KD.
Oh.
Let's get it in. We got to ask KD this week. Wait, for y'all who don't know, I'm going to need you to, for sure, email your questions if you want KD to answer them. She's going to answer them live. We generally go live so that you can see her answering them. And this week, we have one that was sent in from one of our beautiful followers.
She's a listener.
Listener, friend.
Follower. Homie.
The homie.
So, you ready?
So we're gonna go ahead.
I don't like dead air.
You say what now?
I don't like dead air.
Dead air? We'll talk then.
Okay. So how the Ask KD question works is you send me an email. The email address is ask.kayd@gmail.com. When you send me the email, I usually respond to the email at that time, and then we will address the question on the podcast with our listeners and our guests. The question that we have for this week is, you ready?
I am not, but go ahead.
Well, I don't want to. You need help?
Yeah. Go ahead. Keep talking to him. I don't know.
My God.
Give him the email address.
I did.
Give it to him again. Somebody didn't write it down.
It's askask.kayd@gmail.com is the email address to ask your questions. And Ask KD questions can be anything. It could be about relationships. It could be about, I don't know, motherhood. It could be about bullshit. I don't care. I got a lot of answers. I got a lot of shit to say. Mm-hmm. You know, just a D girl from around the way with a whole lot of shit to say.
You better tell her, girl.
It's your girl.
Don't I text you every day like sis?
Yeah. Like, see, advice. some of y'all got the VIP line. Y'all can hit the bat phone, which is what this listener did. She hit the bat phone. She like, you my sister. I don't have to email. She VIP status, you know. Everybody should be VIP at some time. I get a phone for y'all, y'all. Y'all can't have my personal number.
No, they can't.
I got time for people to be playing on my phone.
I'm just coming. I'm gonna. Oh.
Or you could just come over. It's fine. Not everybody, though. Not everybody. Famous. I can't just, you know. And my kids off the chain.
Off the chain.
My teenage boys, they've been had you crying. You ready?
All right. Yep, let's go.
Okay. So the Ask KD question of the week. I don't have a partner, and I'm sexually deprived. How should I go about getting some D? Asking for myself. So my advice is hit the club scene. Like, if you're just looking to fuck, you know, you hit the club scene. I can get you a couple emails to get on a couple party lists, little sex parties, you know. It just depends on what you're looking for. Are you looking for a relationship? Or are you looking for some sex? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, we all need a nut. So that's my advice. Hit the club scene. All Tinder. Right. Swipe left. I don't know. Stay off a Grindr though, because I heard that's just for men. So, but Tinder.
Heard of Grindr.
They say it's for gay men.
Oh.
I heard about it on Love and Hip Hop. Bobby Lights.
I was about to say Bobby Lights.
Bobby Lights be on Grindr. Mad as hell because his nigga be on it too.
Yikes.
So what y'all think? What was y'all advice to our listener?
Miesha, what you say?
I would say the same thing.
Yeah, you got to go out.
I mean, if you're not strictly with nobody, what else? What other way is it to do?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's what I...
I mean, the bad part about it is I've been out of the scene for 20 years. So I don't really know how people hook up nowadays. But hooking up is so common.
Yeah, it's so easy.
Instagram.
Shit, that's where my boys get it from.
Instagram. You got to hit them on Instagram. Like, what you doing?
Slide in the DMs.
Yeah, you just got to slide in the DM with the man.
Yeah.
And also, you can feel free to hit us up on Facebook because there is a nice little party that's coming up within the next few weeks. So if y'all trying to get down and get on that list, hit me up and I can let you know some more information about it. Y'all, if you're not in that Facebook group, you are missing out. For sure. Follow us on Instagram. If you're not in that Facebook group, you're missing out. The Facebook group is private. So when we get in, I'm telling you, we goes in on that.
It's off the chain, y'all.
It's off the chain. Pictures, conversation, everything.
Facebook, yeah. Don't you got Facebook?
I mean, barely. I don't never use it.
Oh, okay. I could.
I just had it to promote that restaurant.
So our social media, you can follow us on Twitter at RelationshipR20. You can follow us on YouTube at Relationship Reality Podcast, on Tumblr, Relationship Reality Podcast. We are on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Play Music. That's J Phone. He's so rude. Podbeam, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, and YouTube.
Okay.
Tumblr.
Can I get that one more time? Because everybody been asking me.
On what?
Everything.
So you can follow us on Twitter, Relationship R20. YouTube, Relationship Reality Podcast. Tumblr, Relationship Reality Podcast. Spotify, Apple Podcast. Podbeam, Google Play Music. We are Relationship Reality Podcast. It'll be a picture of me and Deontay on there. And go on there. Subscribe, like, share with your friends. Tell your homeboy, homegirls. Mm-hmm. You need some sex advice, we got it.
There it is, man. And that's our show. I want to leave y'all with this, man. Your relationship will only be as good as you are. So if you want your relationship to be better, then you get better. Don't put it all on your spouse. Don't put it all on your mate. Don't put it all on that other person. If you want it to be better, you get better and the relationship to get better. This is your boy, man, DTM Deontay the Motivator.
And your girl, KD.
And we are Relationship Reality. We will see you guys next week. Peace.
To them. Me.